Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Glorelys Mora.
I just moved to Los Angeles from New York. Thank you, because I found out my boyfriend was ugly. For 3 months, I didn't notice he was ugly because he was paying for everything, right? So there was no need to make eye contact. He was paying for my Gucci bags, my trips to the Dominican Republic, my Netflix account, right? Then one day he asked me to go half on the bill and I was like, ew. Is this who you are? Have you always been bald? And broke? And a Scorpio? That's not my brand. I cannot be with you. The truth is that my ex, he actually suffocated me with a pillow. Don't get sad. I take a little bit of accountability. I'm annoying. And I'm a Gemini. Thank you. Gemini's in the building. And I talk in my sleep. Yeah. I tend to ask a lot of questions like, what do you want for dinner? What's your 5-year plan? Why are you cheating on me? Men don't like that. Boom, smothered. When I look back to that relationship, sometimes I wish I would have stayed with him. Hear me out. I'm a dumb bitch. But also, he had a dishwasher. Yeah. And a dishwasher is a beautiful machine that solves generational trauma. Every time I do a load, I forgive my mom just a little bit. As a woman, it is your responsibility to spend your 20s fixing men up for the next bitch. Espérate, hear me out. That's what Britney Snow did, Anna Faris, me. I spent all of my 20s opening SoundCloud accounts for underground rappers that I believed in. Okay? I opened up so many businesses on LegalZoom so that the next bitch can get an established man. That's feminism, looking out for the next girl. I had to call up my ex's ex because she fucked up the dumb bitch Henry Ford assembly line. I was like, Rebecca, what were you doing in your last relationship? You sent me a man that was broken, had anger issues, and had factory defects. He didn't have a resume? Ew. He didn't have global entry? Ew. He didn't know how to parallel park? Disgusting. How can I be a passenger princess with a man that doesn't have control over his vehicle? A man that can't parallel park, that doesn't have control over his vehicle, doesn't have control over his life, therefore can't take care of you. Do the math. I was like, Rebecca, come get your refurbished iPhone 8 back immediately. Because that's what men are, refurbished. They go from one relationship to the next with just one update. Some of y'all here tonight with some refurbished iPhones. Not you pointing, I'm done. You know, the truth is that men don't really change after a breakup. They just go and find the next stupid bitch, and I just always happen to be her. And no one will remind you that you're not where you want to be, especially in your love life, like that one family member you don't like. I have this one aunt, her name is Cristela. She's a fucking bitch. Every time I get around her, she'll always ask me these questions about my dating life. She'll be like, why are you single? I'm like, Cristela, I've been on all the dating apps. I've been on LinkedIn, Cash App, Venmo. Everyone is broke and ugly right now. The economy's bad. Or then she'll try to make a little recommendation. She's like, why don't you get a Dominican man on WhatsApp? And then she'll pause and be like, oh, tú no hablas español. And I'm like, bitch, I do speak Spanish. Just not to you. But I never know how to say it to her in Spanish. So she right. And I just want women like Grisela to stop thinking that relationships define you, that they make everything. I also went to college. That doesn't count. And sometimes to remind her, I'll throw out an SAT word in the middle of the argument. I'll be like, it will behoove you, bitch, to mind your business when it comes to my dating life and to focus on them kids that got you blocked on Instagram. That got personal. I'm gonna save my family this year. I'm going to say, make some noise. You're going to save your family. You're the people that are going to save your family. Make some noise. I'm going to save my family. And I'm going to save all the stupid bitches, too. I'm going to be a hoe, and I'm going to lead by example. All right. Okay, there's some hoes in here. I like that. And hoes are not a monolith. That's another SAT word. It's different. It's different kinds of hoes. You have your dumb hoe. They believe in love. And that's stupid. Love is not real. Love is like crypto. May or may not be a scam. Probably a scam. And I know I had a crypto boyfriend. He told me we were going to the moon. And I gave him both of my stimulus checks. And we're not on the moon. Right? Then you have your bougie hoe. She only sucks dick in Portugal. And I'm not saying that's me. But this summer, I'm going to be in Lisbon. Thank you. For those of us with global entry, that's the capital of Portugal. And if you take anything from my set tonight, I just want you to do better. Stop sucking dick locally. In the Bronx? Ew. In Bakersfield? Ew. In Wichita? I don't even know where that's at. That sounds nasty. Ew. Go to Italy, have a little bruschetta. Go to France, have a little Cabernet. Because what do men give you here? A headache and tap water, and that's poor. That's been my time, everybody. Have a good night. Thank you.